50,000 disciples of Jesus pray in Washington, D.C. President Trump nominates Amy Coney Barrett to the Supreme Court. The first presidential debate happens, and China rewrites the Bible. I'm Scott Patton, and it's Friday on the Go Bold Network, and welcome to the Weekly Wrap. Let's go bold. Whoa! Welcome to the Weekly Wrap. You will see the good, the bad, the ugly on the Go Bold Network, and this week is no different. We have some really good news stories that I'm going to share with you, but we also have some bad ones, unfortunately. But what I'd like you to do, if you could, just hit that subscribe button, either to our Facebook page or our YouTube channel. We get a lot of views on Facebook, and we're trying to increase them on YouTube as well. But hit that subscribe button to the Go Bold Network or our Facebook page. But also hit that like button. We'd sure appreciate it. And we'd sure appreciate it if you would share as well and leave us a comment. I would love to answer your comment. And we really appreciate your comments. You know, on the Go Bold podcast today, we are sponsored by Hanna-Bass Productions. Any picture, anywhere, anytime. Let Hanna-Bass Productions take care of all your filming and your production and your photography needs. They specialize in church services, weddings, birthday parties, senior pictures, funerals, proms, you name it. They can also set your business up for success with focus commercials on multiple social media platforms, or build a simple video for your business webpage, or set up a video security system for your home or your business. Contact Caleb Hanna-Bass at 580-583-6092 or visit their website at hannabassproductions.com. That's hannabassproductions.com. Or follow them on Facebook at Hanna-Bass Productions, at Hanna-Bass Productions. Every day on the Go Bold Network, we like to post a Bible verse with commentary. And usually we like to have a cool picture with it. And based on the number of likes and shares and comments we have on that particular verse during the week, we select it for the verse of the week. Drum roll, please. Do we hear a drum roll? I hear it coming. I hear it coming. And bam. Yes, indeed. We have it. It is Galatians 6:22. And I read God's word. I very love to read God's word. Carry each other's burdens. And in this way, you will fulfill the law of Christ. You know, folks, probably more time in the history of America and the history of our country, we need to be good neighbors. Oh, man, we need good neighbors out there. You see, when we carry other people's burdens, it not only gives us a blessing, but I want everybody to understand, we don't carry burdens for other people to get Jesus. We don't. But rather, the whole situation is, we carry those burdens because we have Jesus in our heart. That's that simple. It's that hard. You know, when we help carry a burden for someone, it glorifies our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But I will tell you from my own experience, it does something to you that you're psych. It makes you feel really good inside, and it also increases the power of the Holy Spirit inside you. So if you get a chance to go help somebody today or this week, go out and do it. Go out there and lift that burden. Now, for our top stories, and this is an awesome story, folks. 50,000 disciples, actually it was over 50,000, march on Washington, D.C. to do one thing this last Saturday, and that is pray. Only on the Go Bold Network would this be considered the top story of the week. And I say that because it was barely even mentioned in the mainstream news media outlets. Nobody ran with this story. Very few even talked about it. And that's 50,000 disciples who marched on Washington for one reason, and that is to pray. That is powerful. Now, why is this a top story on the Go Bold Network? Well, call me crazy and call me whatever you want, but that I believe 50,000 people in our nation's capital on their knees praying to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is probably the single biggest thing that has happened to America this year. It's that simple. You know, folks, in 1 John chapter 5, verse 14, it says this very plainly, and I quote God's word, This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. Those are powerful words, folks. And when you see those 50,000 disciples of Jesus out there on the National Mall, on their knees, praying to our Lord and Savior, we know that powerful things are going to happen to our country. Our nation needs prayer more than any time in our history. I was reading the other day about a pastor named Andrew Murray, and he once said, "The man who mobilizes the Christian church to pray will make the greatest contribution to world evangelism." And I believe that with all my heart. My prayer is that God will heal our nation. Because here's what I want all of you to understand. Christianity can and will survive with or without America. It's that simple. But America has no chance of surviving without Christianity. It's that simple. It's that hard. This is why we've got to pray. We've got to be on our knees in America, us as disciples. We've got to get America on their knees in prayer. And Christians across America, they came together to pray for our country and its healing and its amid this whole COVID-19 pandemic. The recent civil strife we see where Antifa and Black Lives Matter have caused massive destruction and massive financial damages on some of our poorest communities. And in some cases, we've seen rape and murder out of these organizations. We need to pray for America. And this prayer event was focused on healing the country and letting the gospel unite the country. That's what the gospel does. It unites the country. Franklin Graham prayed these words, "Father, our country is in trouble and we need your help." That's what Franklin Graham prayed. And he prayed specifically for our president. And Vice President Pence was also among the multiple speakers on the Lincoln Memorial steps who discussed the presidency, the Supreme Court. Vice President Pence urged the crowd to pray for the armed forces, and we do need to pray for our armed forces, the executive branch, our Congress. And he also said the remarkable women that the president will nominate to fill the seat of the Supreme Court. And today, at this prayer march, you will continue a great tradition, Pence said. Since the founding of our nation, the American people and our leaders have gone to prayer in challenging times. And what he said was right, folks. These are challenging times. After the rally, disciples walked around, and they had 8 sites around the National Mall. I would have loved to have been there, where you had prayer participants were asked to pray on specific topics. And at each of these sites, this was including for police officers, they desperately need our prayers, government leaders, ending abortion. Oh, man, what a prayer that would be. What a blessing that would be to see abortion, all the slaughters of innocent babies killed across America. And especially we talk about this whole thing about systematic racism, and we do see systematic racism when we've seen 1 million African-American babies murdered since 1973. That is systematic racism. That's wiping out a whole race and a whole generation of one race. But the most thing we pray for is salvations across America. Former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee stated, "These people have come from all over America at their own expense. They come to pray for our country." He said this while hosting the event via live stream. They're here to solve the trouble our land is in. And indeed, it is, but the prayers of God will solve our nation's problems. That leads us to our next story. This very same day, President Donald Trump nominated Amy Coney Barrett for the Supreme Court nomination. Now, we talked about this, her as a candidate last week on the Gobo podcast, and we also talked about this, that she would be, she was one of the candidates we talked about, and we talked about that she would be a strict constitutionalist and a devout Christian. Now, just as we had predicted on this very show last Friday on the Gobo Network, Judge Barrett has already experienced multiple horrible attacks from, honestly, the Democrats and the mainstream media for her religious beliefs. You could not imagine this would happen any other time in our history. And it didn't take the media and the Democratic Party long to start hurling horrid insults at this Catholic Christian lady and a Supreme Court nominee, Amy Coney Barrett. Immediately, the attack centered on her devout religious faith. Now, on Friday, you may know a man named Bill Maher. He's a mainstream media mouthpiece for the Democratic Party, and he said this on the show, and I just want you to watch how vile and horrible this is. Let's play the tape.
But apparently, the pick is going to be this Amy Comey. We'll all be saying this name a lot, I'm sure, because she's a f***ing nut. Religion. I was right about that one, too. Amy Coney Barrett, Catholic, really Catholic. I mean really, really Catholic, like speaking in tongues.
Now, while Maher is known as an anti-Christian bigot and his extreme atheist views, this attack against a woman Supreme Court candidate was not only bigoted, but it was unprecedented, and it showed a great deal of misogyny. Yes, I said that. But the misogynist Maher wasn't the only one who went after her religion. Democratic senators and their cronies in the media instantly began attacking Barrett for her Catholic faith. The strategy is this, and smearing her as an extreme jurist that cannot be on the Supreme Court because of her extreme religious views. Just like Bill Maher said, you know, she believes in these things called the Holy Ghost. Can you imagine that? Well, MSNBC host Nicole Wallace immediately attacked Barrett's Catholic faith, and during her show, she asked her panel this: what do you think the line of questioning will be about that association? Well, let's define that association. Her association, Wallace referring to, was her association with Christianity. Seriously? The greater picture in this spiritual battle and in the next several weeks, Judge Amy Barrett will desperately need our prayers, because I'm going to tell you guys, Satan and his allies will throw the absolute house at her and her children. And that, yes, I said that, her children, because that's the next form of attack. You see, politicians and the media member are also implying that Barrett and her husband adopted two beautiful black Haitian children only for political expediency. Isn't that stupid? For political expediency. Now, these children were adopted long before she became a Supreme Court nominee. But according to this guy, he's even called an anti-racist author, and he's a direct consultant. His name's Ibrahim Kendi. And by the way, there's nothing anti-racist about Ibrahim Kendi. He's probably one of the most racist people that I've came across. But Kendi claims that Barrett and her husband are, his words, white colonizers who adopted. Isn't that horrible? That makes Barrett a, and this is according to him, a white colonizer of black children in order to civilize the savage children as superior ways of white people. Yes, somebody said that. And that was this horrible, horrible man said that about Judge Barrett and her family. He also said that they're using these little black children they've had for quite some time now as props in their lifelong pictures of denial. Yes, their whole denial. These despicable comments come from a so-called anti-racist, or about as racist as it gets. But the larger question is this. Like many in the media today, they're just flat-out lies. It's just non-truths. And they just put it out. They print it. And, of course, you see all the social media platforms, they print it. All the mainstream media places print it. But I want you to see what God's Word says. Because God warns us about this. The Apostle Paul warns us about this. 2 Corinthians, we're going to show you a verse on the screen, where 2 Corinthians says this: and even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. Did you catch that? It's veiled to those who are perishing. So we don't really have to worry about these people. We got to pray for them because they're soulless. They don't have a soul. And in their case, the God of this world, yes, indeed, and the god of this world is the government, the socialists, the communists that have infiltrated our country, has blinded the minds of unbelievers to keep them from seeing the light and the glory of Christ, who is in the image of God. That's exactly why you're seeing these horrible attacks against Judge Barrett and her family. And I will tell you, they're misogynist and they're racist attacks. Now, we're seeing the glory of Christ fixing to be revealed in all this process. And here's what's causing this, folks. It's driving Satan and his demons absolutely insane. Yes, indeed it is. Romans 8:28 says, "And we know that all things work for the good, for those who love God and are called according to his purpose." Judge Barrett is called according to his purpose. Please keep Judge Barrett and her entire family in your prayers. They desperately need them. Now, it's that time for the Stuck on Stupid Story of the Week. Let's hear that those donkeys, the donkeys whine. I can hear them right now. Play that donkey sound. And yes, you see it right here, Stuck on Stupid Story of the Week. Oh, yes. And here's what it is. The Chinese government rewriting the Bible. Can you imagine that? Rewriting the Bible. This Chinese textbook says that rewrites the Bible to claim Jesus actually stoned a woman to death. But before we get to that, the Stuck on Stupid segment is sponsored by none other than CNI Guess. Don't settle for bad gas. No, sir. Settle on CNI Guess. They pass gas with class at CNI Guess. They can do inspections of your propane tanks to make sure there are no silent but deadly gas problems. Oh, yes, indeed. No worries about those, you know, those loud gas explosions that sometimes you have on holiday dinner parties. You don't have to worry about it because CNI Gas will take care of those. So let it rip. Take the pressure off and don't settle for bad gas. Dial CNI Gas at 580-429-3591. That's 580-429-3591. That's CNI Gas at CNIGas.com. Go visit them and see them. Now, according to the Christian Post, this communist textbook that is being used in Chinese schools falsifies a biblical account found in John chapter 8, verses 11 through 3. Now, this is not the first time the Chinese government has done that. They have been manipulating the Bible for a number of years. In fact, I know that it's very hard for many cases for missionaries to go out there because you got to make sure that you do indeed have a translated King James version or NIE version that's translated into the native tongue, because this textbook, it was rewritten to claim that the textbook claims that Jesus murdered a woman who was found in adultery and said to is a sinner. Now, the textbook published by the government-run university Electronic Science and Technology Press states this is what the version has been changed to. Now, you guys know the story as well as I do. The crowd wanted to stone the woman to death as per their law, but Jesus said, "Let the one who has never sinned throw the first stone." Hearing this, they slipped away one by one. When the crowd dispersed, this is where it gets stupid. Jesus stoned the sinner to death, saying, "I am a sinner. I too am a sinner. But the law could only be executed by men without blemish. The law would be dead." You've got to be kidding me. Seriously? So here's what they're doing, guys. They are taking the Chinese Communist government is turning the Bible into a communist manifesto. That's what they're doing. And they're changing, and it drip, 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 and it drips all the time. And it does. And so we have got to fight this tooth and nail. We've got to make an issue to get them real Bibles. And here's the problem. The Catholics in mainland China and Christians are distressed about this, this distortion of biblical accounts and reports from the UCA News. And I quote them, "I want everyone to know that the Chinese Communist Party has always tried to distort history of the church, to slander the church, and to make people hate our church." A parishioner who uploaded the new textbook on social media was quoted as saying in his post that this is what he said. And another Catholic in mainland China was also identified only as Paul, was quoted as saying, "The same pattern has been repeated every year. but the church has never fought back or received or asked for apology that it deserves. Now, I will tell you guys, the Catholic Church has done has taken a lot of money from communist China, and we've got to force them to not do this. And because I will tell you this, and what they want is they want Catholic bitches from China. And this is what they hold over their head. But the problem is, many times the Chinese government's winning. We've got to stop this. We've got to keep praying for them. But you know, the news of this distortion of the Bible, of the Chinese textbook, comes when the Vatican and China are expected to renew a deal on the appointment of Catholic bishops in China. Now, the United States has advised Pope Francis against it due to the severe violations of human rights and religious freedoms in communist country. So if you're some of our Catholic brothers and sisters, tell your priest that this is not acceptable. The story teaches that the law and the Chinese Communist Party are good and pure, and it transcends into impure human beings. And that's what they want to try to represent in all this. Even the officers are corrupted by their decisions, should not be accepted because honest or corrupted, they represent the party and the party's a law, and it should never be questioned. That's what the magazine wrote in this story. Now, I want to thank Christian Post for publishing the story. And if you guys get a chance, read Christian Post. They've got some great, great stories. But that is our Stuck on Stupid story of the week. Now, if you have a good Stuck on Stupid story, we would love to see it. So you see that big banner there. Email us at thegobopodcast at gmail.com. That's thegobopodcast at gmail.com. Put attention, Stuck on Stupid. We would love to have your Stuck on Stupid story of the week. And finally, wow, Tuesday night was perhaps the most exhausting night I think I've been at probably in a number of years, and that was watching the presidential debate. Now, okay, you don't have to take a political side on this. This is our last segment. But the presidential debate, it started out between President Donald Trump and former Vice President Joe Biden. But it quickly turned in to the Chris Wallace show about Wallace, where Wallace, I'm going to tell you, folks, he was just frankly awful. He was terrible. His performance was horrible. And frankly, it ruined the debate. Wallace, who is a Fox News reporter, turned in probably the worst debate moderator in presidential history. It was a horrible night for Fox News and probably one of the worst things I've seen in Fox News in a great number of years. Chris Wallace was terrible. His questioning was terrible. His demeanor was terrible. He interrupted. He was trying to make the debate all about him and not about the candidates. And what really disappointed me the most were his questions. You know, it's not like he just was named the debate chair. He's had weeks and months to prepare these questions. And these were the worst questions I've ever seen in any debate. A high school kid could have come up with better questions. I cannot believe to this day that Chris Wallace hosts a major Sunday news show. He was horrible. The way he worded his questions, he could not hide his intellectual bias. In fact, Wallace's lack of strategic sophistication frankly amazes me. And I will tell you, folks, as the debate went on, it got worse and it got worse. And he was unabashedly going for Trump's throat the entire debate while throwing Biden lifeline after lifeline after lifeline. And, you know, I could see, you know, there might be some biases. Everybody is going to have their biases. But when you are moderating a presidential debate and you are the only moderator in that debate, okay, and you're the only moderator in the debate, you have to be fair. You have to be, as Fox says, fair and balanced. But I'll tell you, folks, Fox News is not fair and balanced. This wasn't fair and balanced. And the more Trump poked at Chris Wallace got so frustrated at one point, I thought he was just going to just blow a gasket. And, you know, I was watching this, and so I decided, is this just me feeling this way, or does the rest of America feel this way? So what I did is I tweeted out that Wallace's performance was probably the worst presidential debate in presidential history. I put that on Chris Wallace's Twitter handle, and the response I got on my own Twitter page, it absolutely blew up with just people from all over the woodwork agreeing with me and retweeting the tweet that I put out. So then I thought, well, let's go pose this question at the Go Bold Network face page. Now, I want you to take a look at the Go Bold Network face page and see here where you see this. And what you're going to find is you're going to see this was the most popular post we've ever had on our Go Bold Facebook. It went viral. And the response was so overwhelmingly against Wallace. I've never seen anything like it, ever, on our Facebook page. Now, there was also times in this where Wallace would not ask a question, but he would give his commentary, because he's so brilliant. He would give his commentary, and he would take like a Biden campaign talking point, and then he would use that to hit Trump over the head with it. And then he would ask a question. Now, guys, if you haven't watched much TV and watched some of the other networks, this was right out of the CNN, the Communist News Network's playbook. It was right out of CNN's playbook, except this was Fox News. And then President Trump basically told him, am I debating you or am I debating Joe Biden? Now, if you think I'm making this up, I just want you to watch this clip, and you be the judge. Let's play the clip.
So these 4 years have never come up with a comprehensive plan to replace Obamacare. And just this last Thursday, you signed a largely symbolic executive order to protect people with pre-existing conditions 5 days before this debate. So my question, sir, is what is the Trump health care plan?
Right. Well, first of all, I guess I'm debating you, not him, but that's okay. I'm not surprised. Let me just tell you something.
Now, there were times that I thought I was watching Chris Cuomo from CNN instead of Chris Wallace. That's how bad it was. Now, you all see everyone is getting fired up about this election. And you see this. You see it all over the country. You see it on social media. I see it in my church. I see it about everywhere you go. Everybody's worried about the direction of our country. Who's it going to be? Is it going to change with Trump? Is it going to change with Biden? Everybody's saying that America will never be the same. But here's what I'm going to tell you all. Here's what I'm going to tell you. And I want you all to remember this, who is watching this podcast. I've been speaking about this in the pulpit in my preaching for quite some time. I'm going to wake up on Wednesday, November the 4th. It's going to be the night after the election. And I'm going to go out, and I'm going to exercise, and I'm going to go feed my cows. And I'm going to look up in the sky. And you know what I'm going to see? I'm going to see King Jesus will still be on the throne. That's what we've got to remember, guys. You see, God will use whoever for his glory. The reason Donald Trump is in office is for God's glory. It is. And the reason Barack Obama was in office, frankly, God's going to find a way, whether you disagree with his politics or whether they're religious or not, God is going to find a way. They put him there to glorify him and use him for his ultimate purpose. And that's how it's going to be in this election. And yes, as disciples of Jesus, and especially here on the Go Bold Network, I challenge you to go bold. I challenge you not to stay silent when we're talking about abortion or religious rights or religious freedoms. And you know, that's the whole purpose of the Go Bold Network. We're bold. We're going to go out and make disciples, and we're not going to take it from the world because we have the Holy Spirit. So I'm going to ask you guys to go vote and pray and stand up for your candidates. Yes, go vote, pray for them, stand up for them, and stand up for Jesus. But you know what else you got to do? You got to leave the rest up to God. Leave it up to him, because he's going to take care of it. And that, my brothers and sisters in Christ, is how we go bold. Thank you all for joining us today. And please hit that like and subscribe button, and also give us your feedback. I'm Pastor Scott Patton, and may God bless you and see you on the other side of the gate. Go bold.